at 1-800-CALL-FBI. Meantime, funeral services for Lieutenant Joe Glenowitz are scheduled for Monday.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso. The Dow shedding more than 300 points in afternoon trading after the August jobs report shows fewer than expected positions were created last month. And a retired father in Spain, which has the second highest unemployment rate in Europe, trying to help his son, placing an ad offering more than $5,000 to anyone who will give the 39-year-old a job, saying the father of one is desperate, qualified, and responsible. Fox News, we report. You decide.
Are you at risk of identity theft? Yes. A new identity theft happens every 2 seconds. Does giving out your social security number increase risk? Yes. Putting personal information out there increases risk. If you forget your significant other's birthday, are you at risk of getting the silent treatment? Probably. No one likes having their birthday forgotten. But it won't increase the risk of identity theft. Unfortunately, things like shopping and breaches will. That's why LifeLock goes beyond free services that simply monitor credit, from detecting threats to helping resolve issues if your identity is ever compromised. No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor all transactions at all businesses, but LifeLock has proprietary technology to detect threats and a dedicated resolution staff to help restore your good name. Is getting the silent treatment fun? No, but it's a walk in the park compared to having your identity stolen. Protection starts at $9.99 a month. For 10% off, go to LifeLock.com and use promo code NEWS.
We want to talk right down to earth in a language that everybody here can easily understand.
And now it's time for the voice.
Don't know how to put this, but I'm kind of a big deal.
I want you to get up right now
and go to the window,
open it,
stick your head out and yell,
Hayden Bond! Dominic!
The voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
You know I don't speak Spanish. In English, please.
Look in my eyes, what do you see? The cult of personality. I know your anger, I know your dreams. I've been everything you wanna be. Oh, I'm the cult of personality. I'm the cult of personality, the cult of personality, the cult of personality.
Good Friday afternoon. Welcome to the Voice of Ocala on a overcast. Looks like about to start raining Friday afternoon. I'm Tom Schmitz, coming to you live from the palatial studios of WOCA Radio, just outside the food court entrance to the Paddock Mall. Susan Del Rio walks by making faces at us. That's wonderful. It is Ask the Cops, brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. And this Friday, we're joined by the county's top cop, Sheriff Chris Blair. Sheriff, how are you this afternoon?
I'm doing good. It's Friday. Weekend coming.
For some reason, your microphone doesn't seem to be working. Yeah, that ain't right. Something's wrong there. Let's try it again. How you doing, Sheriff?
I'm doing well.
See, that's much better. See how?
Okay, you got me on now.
You actually press the right button, it's amazing how this radio thing works.
Well, I'm glad you knew what button to hit. That's
and
very important.
You brought in with you Deputy Paul Bloom of the Crime Prevention Unit. Deputy, how are you?
I'm good, Tom.
Now, Deputy, what actually is the Crime Prevention Unit?
The Crime Prevention is a more proactive approach to fighting crime, trying to get out there ahead of the curve, so to speak, and educating the public. Quite a bit goes into it. You see a lot of our crime prevention programs around town already that are in place, and we're evolving as we go, coming up with new ideas and new ways to get out in front of crime.
Would those kiosks we see everywhere around, would those be part of crime prevention?
That's a big part of it right now, and that's catching on like wildfire with other agencies and doing well for us.
I like when I say something about the kiosk, the sheriff gets a little smile on his face because he remembers. The stories that make me smile about the kiosk are
There are people who see their face on the kiosk and come in and say, look, here I am. Stop looking for me. I'm just turning yourself in, don't they, Sheriff?
Yeah, we have. We've had people see themselves on the kiosk, drive themselves to the Marion County Jail, and turn themselves in. So it's a good program, and we got good news. Walmart's came on board with us, so we're in the process of now building some new kiosks. So we'll have them placed here not too long. They'll be in every Walmart in the county. I think we have a total of six, so they'll be at their entrances. So what's good about it is that if they have a crime that occurs in their business, we can take their information, their surveillance photos, and put them right back to the kiosk. So if the person commits a crime in one Walmart and he goes to another Walmart, he's probably going to see himself on the kiosk.
Now, we were talking before the show started about different scams going around in the county, and one y'all put out on the airwaves that you told people to watch out for is one that I just find amazing that people fall for it. But I always shouldn't be amazed at the way people fall for it. But there's people calling saying that they're representing the sheriff's office. They're not saying what sheriff's office they're representing, but they're representing the sheriff's office and saying, you've missed jury duty, or I can help you get out of jury duty by paying me right now. How many reports have y'all had of that, Sheriff?
I don't know the number, but I know it is an ongoing problem here soon, and you're exactly right that they're not identifying what sheriff's office. They're just saying that they're with a sheriff's office and making the phone call to citizens, and we've had a multitude of these calls. So we're just warning people to know that if this is the way to do it. If they tell you that's a lieutenant, ask the lieutenant for a different number and then call him back, and he should have his name on his phone, or you can help verify that he is a lieutenant with the sheriff's office.
And usually if you do something like that, the criminal's going to hang up on you anyway.
He's not going to give you a number in the first place.
Well, because criminals like that are opportunists. If you balk just a little bit, they just hang up on you and move on to the next, trying to find the easy person that'll just give them the money.
We call it a target. They're looking for an easy target. So we don't want our citizens out there to become targets. So take that opportunity to say, hey, I may believe that you're a lieutenant with the sheriff's office, but if you give me a number, I'd like to call you back.
Just before we go to break, I want to give you kudos to your department and all your officers. I watched a video yesterday from your helicopter unit, the unit that the county commission was trying to figure out a way not to pay for, but they finally did. I don't know how they actually increased
the MSTU because it was in a general fund, which really, that's where it belongs. Both our aviation and our warrant unit should be in the general fund because we service multiple municipalities here, the city of Ocala,
exactly.
Bellevue, Dunellen. But they had asked me to move it to the MSTU last year, which was a total of about 1.6, and if you remember, they didn't want to fund it.
I remember.
Once they asked me to
imagine that
to
the
move
county commission
it, so I moved it.
Fund from.
I moved it over there, and it was a little bit of this and that, but eventually they came through and they did fund that.
Well, I watched a video yesterday that was posted on the Marion County Sheriff's Office Facebook page of a pursuit of a car who one of your deputies. Saw a car, he had a trainee actually with him, and saw a car sitting on the side of the road, blacked out. The trainee turned back to look. When he turned back to look, the car took off with its lights still off, blacked out. That's suspicious.
That's a hint.
that's
we call that a clue.
Yeah, that's a clue. Yeah. So the deputies gave pursuit, lost them, but then relocated them again, blacked out. They took off again. A pursuit ensued, and the bad guys were eventually contained and arrested. And all of it on video, all of it where nobody can say there was any kind of shenanigans by officers and their civil rights were violated. It was just a good takedown of people who were probably up to no good because that's how they acted.
Yeah, I think they had burglar tools, and they arrested them for other different unrelated charges. So they weren't up to any good, and so they're now visiting our jail.
Your department did. I mean, that video, it's amazing. People, you see videos from Cop Watch and everything, and that a good producer, by the way, like like I do with Southern Pigskin Tonight, the football show we do here, a good producer can make a video look like it's not been altered and it all is one good situation.
Absolutely. And, you know, and that's what we've been challenged with is sometimes, you know, these cop blockers and others, they throw out video and they've been cut. You know, they leave off the fact that the officer asked the person to step out of the car 20 times. So it's one of those things where, you know, just you may look at it, but it may not be factual in nature.
Now, before we go to break, Officer Bloom, Deputy Bloom, so these videos shown on Facebook and stuff like that, are they sometimes tools in preventing crimes as well? Because people know the sheriff's department around here has got all these tools. They don't play. I need to stay out of Marion County.
That's been a very big help for us. I know, just coming from, I've been working on the road for the last few years, and I can tell you it helps. People see it. We went from having 1,700 followers on Facebook when we started to now over 37,000. And that 37,000, and they're sharing it, and they're sharing it, is getting out there, and people are seeing that. And yeah, that, I think that makes somebody think, yeah, I don't want to get caught.
Just like people know, don't go mess with Grady down in Polk County.
That's right.
Well, they know we're going to put you on the kiosk, you know, and there's, you know, we've always said that our citizens are our eyes and ears, and it's so true to that statement. They see more, they hear more than we can. We can't be everywhere, so we depend on our citizens to do the right thing and report crime. And if they know where someone's at, they just call Crime Stoppers. 368 stop and report it. They can get a reward, and it's all anonymous. We don't know who it is and don't really care who it is. We just want to make sure that we remove the bad guy from the street that has a warrant on him.
We're going to take a break. When we come back, I want to talk to you about something that's very sobering. I looked at the statistics. I just went onto the website, Officers Killed in the Line of Duty 2015.
Yeah.
And there's heart attacks and there's car wrecks and everything. But I just looked at the month of August. And I want to read that to you when I get back. And we need to have a good discussion, a frank discussion about the dangers faced by your officers and officers all over the country, because it almost seems like war has broken out.
Well, you know, I'll say this real quick. You know, on my way here, we're now chasing a homicide suspect. I got the aviation up. We got K-9 en route. We got multiple units en route. So as we're sitting right now, our officers are out trying to
In harm's way,
trying to locate a subject that is in a wooded area right now. So we hope that we can take him into custody, and all of our officers are safe at the end of the day.
We're talking with Sheriff Chris Blair, the Marion County Sheriff's Office. Deputy Paul Bloom, he's part of the Crime Prevention Unit of the Marion County Sheriff's Office. It is Ask the Cops, brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. We'll be right back after this timeout on WOCA, The Source.
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, in everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Do you experience body aches, joint or muscle pain all over your body? Does it keep you up at night, interfere with your day, and leave you feeling tired and in pain? You could be suffering from fibromyalgia. RenStar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study of investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 18 and 75 who have had widespread body pain or tenderness for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication at no cost. Compensation for time and travel will be provided, and insurance is not necessary to participate. If you experience body aches or suffer from fibromyalgia and would like to find out more information about this fibromyalgia study, please call RenStar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's RenStar Medical Research, 352-629-5800. RenStar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Each morning, we wake up thankful to live in a free nation with liberty and justice for all. But sometimes those liberties can be put in jeopardy, and you may have questions about what to do or who to call. Let Doc Blanchard of Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland help you find the answers. Attorneys at law since 1974 and located in downtown Ocala. If you have legal issues, don't go it alone. Call 352-732-7218. Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland, helping protect your liberties every day.
Big savings on carpet and vinyl right now at DIY. It's the big pre-Labor Day carpet and vinyl sale happening now through Saturday.
Take an additional 15% off their already low outlet prices. On sale now, fiberglass pre-hung doors starting at only $119. Insulated fiberglass French doors, only $399. In stock and ready to be picked up. All wood kitchen cabinets in stock and ready to go. From all wood cabinets to granite vanity tops, DIY has you covered. Don't overpay at one of those big box stores. Put more money in your wallet and save big at DIY Home Center Outlet. Need tile, laminate flooring? DIY has it. Need those hard-to-find mobile home parts? Look no further than DIY Home Center Outlet. Tubs, showers, doors, and windows. It's all at DIY. Whether you're looking for savings on your mobile home or traditional home, DIY Home Center Outlet is the place to get great deals every day to save you money. Just a mile and a half east of I-75 on Highway 27 or DIYHomeCenterOutlet.com. And for new items and daily specials, check them out on Facebook. The DIY Home Center Outlet.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source, 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
To the Voice of Ocala on a Friday, Ask the Cops Friday, brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. In the studio today is Sheriff Chris Blair of the Marion County Sheriff's Office and Deputy Paul Bloom. He works in the Crime Prevention Unit at the Marion County Sheriff's Office. Before we went to break, we were talking about law enforcement officers killed in the line of duty. And we know we had the one executed in a Houston suburb last week. Last Friday night, Friday a week ago, we had the officer in Chicago that, for all intents, for everything I can read, looks like he ran into a trap. Yeah. They haven't said that yet, but I'm chasing two white male subjects, one black male subject. That was his last radio transmission before they found him deceased. That sounds like a setup to me. That's just mine. So I went back. I said, how many officers die in the line of duty every year? And when you think of line of duty, heart attacks happen, car accidents happen. But I just went back and looked at, so I said, well, that's, I didn't realize the massive amount of officers that die every year.
Mm-hmm. A large number.
It's a very large number. And so I went back and looked just at the month of August. Deputy Sheriff Delton Daniels of the Marlboro County Sheriff's Office He was killed in a gunfire. Police Officer Sean Michael Bolton of the Memphis Police Department, gunfire. Police Officer Thomas LaSalle of the Shreveport Police Department, gunfire. Then you got Deputy Sheriff Carl Howell, Carson City Sheriff's Office, Nevada, gunfire. Senior Trooper Stephen Vincent, Louisiana State Police, gunfire. We know that. That was the one that got shot by the guy who, the drunk guy who had wrecked his truck into a ditch.
Right.
You got Police Officer Henry Nelson, Sunset Police Department, Louisiana, gunfire. You got Deputy Sheriff Darren Goforth, Harris County Sheriff's Office, Texas. That's the one that was executed last Friday, gunfire. And Lieutenant Charles Joseph Galinowitz, Fox Lakes Police Department, Illinois, gunfire.
Four in the last 9 days.
Four in the last 9 days, but in the month of August, nine killed by gunfire.
Yes.
That's an astounding number to me.
Nine
officers killed in the line of duty by gunfire just last month.
I have said this, when I became the sheriff, I had the opportunity to attend the National Sheriff's Conference, and all the sheriffs, I wouldn't say all, but I would say majority of us in the country were forewarned that we were going to start seeing this type of activity in our country. And it's coming true. It's obvious. I did a post yesterday that this activity that you see is now becoming a reality. And it's a prediction that was made 2 years ago because of our nation and the position that it's in. And, number one, the law enforcement officers out here are outnumbered to a certain extent. Salaries are poor. We just try to get the best of the best. And, I struggle every year trying to get officers at the sheriff's office. We're at 0.92 per 1,000 when the state average is 1.6. Federal average is 2.2. So, we got to continue to add manpower. And also we got to be careful who we hire at the same time. So that's a big job.
Just for your officer safety.
Absolutely.
When I look at these numbers, I think – I know that your officers operate, unless there's a trainee, operate as individual officers and individual
crews. By themselves, 1,650 square miles. Right. I had the opportunity to do a town hall last night in Sandy Acres. And I'm telling you, it took me probably 50 minutes to get there.
Where in the hell is Sandy Acres?
Well, it's out way out on 42 in the southeast corner of Marion County, in the middle of nowhere. But there's way out. And, it's out past, I'm trying to think of the store right there on the corner. But
You're almost in DeLand, aren't you?
Yeah, you're almost there in Lake County. You're almost there. And, I had a good attendance last night, and we talked a lot about these issues and response times and things of that nature and crime in their area. And, at the end of the day, look how long it took me to get there. So when you have an officer that needs backup, think about how far people have to travel to even get an officer back up. Nevertheless, the fact that somebody needs help. And so that's the issues that we've been dealing with, the fact that this county is 1,650 square miles. So it is an issue, and it's something that,
the size of like Rhode Island?
We are the fifth largest county in the state and the size of Rhode Island. So when you got officers out here and they're single officers in their patrol cars, I don't care what side of the county that they're on, they're out there alone, and certainly I have concern, and I want to make sure that I provide all the safety nets that I can for them. So it is alarming, and so we got to continue to do the right thing, as you see across this country, and it's close to us. We had a trooper just shot at in Alachua County a couple weeks ago.
Three weekends ago.
When you look at that, it is reality, and it's touching home, and that's and so it's very alarming.
Let me ask you, Sheriff or Deputy, because you were on the road for a while, do either one of you know, and if you don't, I understand, from the farthest reaches of the northwest corner to the farthest reach of the southeast corner of this county, what's that? Probably an hour and 30-minute travel time?
I would say it took me a long time to get from the northeast 36th Avenue going all the way out to Sandy Acres. So I can only imagine coming from that southeast corner all the way to the northwest corner. You're probably looking at a well over an hour. You're probably looking at an hour and a half.
Probably the same drive times it takes to go from here to Orlando.
You know, it depends on the traffic that you got. You know, I say that, but, you know, it depends on speed, depends on lights, depends on – you just got a lot of obstacles there.
But that gives
you gotta,
people an idea of – we're talking about a time travel in our county from one end, from one corner to the top – from the bottom corner to the top corner is about the equivalent if you drove straight for, down – 441 or down the interstate in the turnpike to Orlando.
And that's the problem, though. You got to remember now, when you're coming from the southeast corner all the way to northwest corner, you don't have no highways.
Yeah, there's no.
These are two lanes, single lane. I mean, so it's not where you're running down 441 or the interstate.
Which is why it takes that much
absolutely.
Time.
Absolutely.
It seems like to me, Sheriff, that you need to go to the county commission and say, I don't need just more money. I need enough money so I can get twice as many officers so they can ride in pairs to have a little protection.
Well, if you look at state agencies, we should be on, and it's a study done, you know, we're at 0.92 per 1,000. The average is 1.6, as I stated, 2.2 on the federal level. So if you look at that, we should have twice as many deputies that we have on the street. So we're not there. I asked for 10 this year. And hoping that I get 10 new deputies. You got to start somewhere. I asked for 10 last year, didn't get them. But we got to worry about calls for service, got to worry about response time, you got to worry about the backup for the officers, and we got to worry about what's coming our way in the future of this country.
Well, I know for a fact, we got about a minute to go before we go to break, but I know for a fact, because I used to live in Hawthorne, I know Orange Springs. I know that the Orange Springs, the Marion County, Putnam County line, because when I go to Interlochen, that's how I go. I go 318 to 315 and 315 that way. I'm at 318, yeah, 315, right through Citra. For an officer to leave, let's say they were leaving the substation on 441 to answer a call of an officer that's at the boat landing, the county boat area at Orange Springs. An officer running full code as fast as he can go with no traffic in front of him. It's 15 minutes at 100 miles an hour.
Maybe.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, maybe. And that's 15 minutes. 15 minutes, your officer could be dead. Somebody could be 12 minutes in the wind. And 12 minutes in the wind for somebody running from a homicide, that's a long time, Sheriff.
Absolutely. And, you know, our times are up. And, you know, I think, you know, I want to hit this before you go to break, is that, you know, in 2013, we had 309,000 calls. Well, there's a misconception out there because we say, well, crime's down in Marion County. And we're proud of that. Crime is down. But here's the, you got to look at crime, those numbers that we're talking about is less than 2% of the 309,000 calls. That's our part ones, burglaries, thefts, robberies,
right,
and homicides.
Well, we're up against a break. We'll get more of those numbers when we get back on Ask the Cops, presented by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer fighting for accident victim justice in 1976 on WOCA, The Source.
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, in everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Are you looking for a durable farm fence to keep your horses enclosed or a beautiful vinyl fence to give that finishing touch to your home? Seminole Fence has over 20 years of experience in providing quality fence products and services for farm and residential properties. Let them surround your property with a fence that provides privacy, security, and stunning appeal. Don't wait. Contact them today at 352-208-0959 for a free estimate. Seminole Fence, working hard to build fences and harder to build relationships.
Do you experience body aches, joint, or muscle pain all over your body? Does it keep you up at night, interfere with your day, and leave you feeling tired and in pain? You could be suffering from fibromyalgia. Renstar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study of investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 18 and 75 who have had widespread body pain or tenderness for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication at no cost. Compensation for time and travel will be provided, and insurance is not necessary to participate. If you experience body aches or suffer from fibromyalgia and would like to find out more information about this fibromyalgia study, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's Renstar Medical Research, 352-629-5800. Renstar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. The community and corporations pitching in to try and find the killers of an Illinois police lieutenant.
A $50,000 reward for information that...
As the vice president of telecom company Motorola Solutions.
Investigators reviewing surveillance footage, so many tips have come in that the FBI has also opened up a tip line at 1-800-CALL-FBI. Meantime, funeral services for Lieutenant Joe Glenowitz are scheduled for Monday.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso. The Dow shedding more than 300 points in afternoon trading after the August jobs report shows fewer than expected positions were created last month. And a retired father in Spain, which has the second highest unemployment rate in Europe, trying to help his son, placing an ad offering more than $5,000 to anyone who will give the 39-year-old a job, saying the father of one is desperate, qualified, and responsible. Fox News, we report. You decide.
Are you at risk of identity theft? Yes. A new identity theft happens every 2 seconds. Does giving out your social security number increase risk? Yes. Putting personal information out there increases risk. If you forget your significant other's birthday, are you at risk of getting the silent treatment? Probably. No one likes having their birthday forgotten. But it won't increase the risk of identity theft. Unfortunately, things like shopping and breaches will. That's why LifeLock goes beyond free services that simply monitor credit, from detecting threats to helping resolve issues if your identity is ever compromised. No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor all transactions at all businesses, but LifeLock has proprietary technology to detect threats and a dedicated resolution staff to help restore your good name. Is getting the silent treatment fun? No, but it's a walk in the park compared to having your identity stolen. Protection starts at $9.99 a month. For 10% off, go to LifeLock.com and use promo code NEWS.
Hello friends, this is Avelio Silvera inviting you to the 23rd annual Silver River Friends of the NRA Dinner. Our upcoming charitable banquet is on September 10th, 2015 at 5:30 p.m. and this year at a brand new location, the Circle Square Cultural Center at On Top of the World. The $50 per person ticket gives you access to games, a live auction, silent auction, raffles, prizes, and a whole lot of fellowship and fun, not to mention a seafood and chicken dinner buffet. You're going to want to be at the Silver River Friends of the NRA dinner on September the 10th at Circle Square Cultural Center. You can call Connie Davis at 352-239-0711. Again, that's Connie Davis at 352-239-0711. This is our charitable fundraising for the year so that we can empower the next generation of defenders of the Second Amendment.
Big savings on carpet and vinyl right now at DIY. It's the big pre-Labor Day carpet and vinyl sale happening now through Saturday. Take an additional 15% off their already low outlet prices. On sale now, fiberglass pre-hung doors starting at only $119. Insulated fiberglass French doors, only $399. In stock and ready to be picked up. All wood kitchen cabinets in stock and ready to go. From all wood cabinets to granite vanity tops, DIY has you covered. Don't overpay at one of those big box stores. Put more money in your wallet and save big at DIY Home Center Outlet. Need tile, laminate flooring? DIY has it. Need those hard-to-find mobile home parts? Look no further than DIY Home Center Outlet. Tubs, showers, doors, and windows. It's all at DIY. Whether you're looking for savings on your mobile home or traditional home, DIY Home Center Outlet is the place to get great deals every day to save you money. Just a mile and a half east of I-75 on Highway 27 or DIYHomeCenterOutlet.com. And for new items and daily specials, check them out on Facebook. The DIY Home Center Outlet.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala. It is Ask the Cops, brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. It's also the Friday drive, so we'll have Chris Spears coming on after the next break to talk to you about Prestige Auto. But right now we have Sheriff Chris Blair in studio along with Deputy Paul Bloom. Deputy, crime prevention, when I think of crime prevention, I think of DARE programs and I think of the guy, the resource officer in the school, and the neighborhood watch program. That's not, while those are crime preventions, that's not necessarily what you deal with in crime prevention.
Right. We're trying to, you know, I know it's an old business cliche of thinking out of the box, but that's really what we're trying to do here. The sheriff's had some ideas with his kiosk, as you know, we've talked about. And something new here that he's also come up with is an alert email system for business owners. And just trying to be creative in what we do and how we prevent crime. And this new program that we're taking on now is basically just a very simple approach, but very effective. I think it's going to work very well. Basically, how it's going to work is we get business email addresses from these businesses. They provide it to me in the sheriff's office. And when we have a crime occur, and this is all about timing and about targeting. We don't have, you know, like the sheriff said, we don't have the luxury of being overstaffed. We're quite the opposite. So it's got to be targeted approach and timed. Meaning when we have a crime occur, and let's say, for instance, at a convenience store, in real time, the deputies on the road are getting this information. Hey, we're looking for this kind of guy, this kind of car. They're getting that information. Unfortunately, the other convenience stores won't get that information until they read the news the next day, maybe, and they may get hit in the meantime. So what we're trying to do is intervene in that and step up. And this is one of these programs that the cost is real low. The only cost to the business owner is going to be the 1 minute of his day to read his email. So it cost him nothing. But it's something that's never been done before, never been tried. We're going to kind of pioneer this like we did with the kiosk, and I think it's going to be successful, and we're going to see some other agencies wanting to get on board.
So basically, you're putting together an email list of all the business owners in the county, or as many as will sign up.
Exactly.
And then they can get real-time alerts about crimes that have happened so they can better prepare to make sure they're not the next victim of that criminal in the crime spree the criminal happens to be doing.
And yes, and this is it's a targeted group. So if
somebody robbed a convenience store, every convenience store owner that had signed up will get a say, hey, somebody just robbed a convenience store at Easy Street. I'm just saying Easy Street and 20th or something. And here's what they look like. Here's what they're wearing. Here's the car that was seen. If you see one of them pull up into your parking lot, take precaution and call 911.
Right. You can just imagine yourself as a bad guy. That may be easier or hard to do. I don't know.
That's true.
Okay.
There was a time in my life it wasn't that difficult to imagine.
Well, you imagine yourself as a you put yourself in that guy's shoes and yeah, you robbed a convenience store. You woke up this morning, so I'm gonna rob a convenience store. Mm-hmm. And we get that information. The deputies are putting that out. We got photos of you, we got video of you, of your vehicle. And immediately within that minute and a half, we've got that information out to you, to the convenience store owners. And we're saying, hey, look for this guy. And then take it a step further, and this convenience store owner goes ahead and prints out your photo, photo of your car and puts it on his front door. And you pull up in his parking lot.
You're going to pull out of his parking lot.
He's already calling me at the sheriff's office, but he's also aware. And right. You see your picture up there. You may not walk in there.
And people say, well, what if he doesn't rob a store anymore? But if you let the convenience store people know, that guy an hour and a half after he robbed the store, 2 hours after he robbed the store, might pull up to another convenience store just to buy gas legally.
Right.
But he's got the information. Hey, the guy that robbed the convenience store 2 hours ago just pulled up here and buying gas.
Well, you know, you sometimes think we deal with brilliant people. I'll tell you, many years ago when I was a robbery detective, you know, we had a robbery where two guys actually went in and did a robbery. And then about, that was around 11 o'clock at night, and then about 2 o'clock in the morning they go in, and the other guy said, hey, you need to go in and do that robbery. He goes in, and the clerk says, man, what are you doing, man? We went to school together. So he went out and told his cousin that, hey, man, she knows me. I can't rob the store. So he goes in and robs the store. So when he gets done robbing the store, now you got to remember, they already robbed one store. They got some cash. Well, while we're responding to that particular robbery, because they called 911 and said, hey, we just been robbed. Well, up the road, they ran out of gas. So they're both sitting with their vehicle when we're responding. So we stopped because we had a vehicle description, and them two were taken into custody. So sometimes it's amazing of these criminals and what they actually do.
Well, Sheriff, you're very proactive in the community. Getting you are a person that says, you've said it numerous times, the eyes and ears to help you out, because you are understaffed and underfunded. People can say, no, he's not. We can move money. You are, okay? The numbers don't lie, and these aren't your numbers. These are studies from other independent
people. These are numbers from, the Florida Department of Law Enforcement.
Right. So all you people who are sitting out there, oh, he's not. Yes, he is. He's underfunded and understaffed. So just hush with thinking he's not. He is, okay? Let's just clear that up. But you've come up with other ways to help. And you use volunteers, you use the community and everything.
1,500 volunteers.
And something else you do is you go around and do these. You did one last night.
Yeah, town halls.
You do the town halls.
Yes, sir.
Where's your next town hall?
Well, we should be scheduled one somewhere in Silver Spring Shores, and I don't have the date here on it, and they may page me with it. But it'll be upcoming in the very near future. But we just did one in Sandy Acres. We did one in Ocklawaha the previous month. So we try to do them monthly. They've been very, very well attended. It gives the citizens the opportunity to talk about issues in their community. It was very inviting to hear the stories last night. You know, and they talked about concerns for deputy sheriffs and being seen in their area. And, you know, and I have to juggle the position to say, look, you know, I'm going to do everything I can because I'm hearing you. I absolutely hear that you need deputy sheriffs in your community. Certainly understand that. We got meth labs out in that area. We got this. We got drug problems. So, you know, I have to look to find ways to put extra manpower out there. And it may be paying off-duty deputies for the time being. And so we're going to look at all the numbers in that area next week, take a look at it, study it. But you know what I told them yesterday? I said, you know what? That's why I'm here. I want to hear it. I don't have to worry about it coming up from the bottom to the top. I'm here before you, whether it's ugly or pretty, it's still I'm going to be able to hear it. So they had a lot of great things to say about the sheriff's office, a lot of great thing about the men and women. But if they have a certain issue, I can resolve that issue. It could be traffic. I was at one off of US 27 recently, and it was a traffic issue. You know what? We diverted some more manpower into that area. We took care of that situation. So these are the best things going, is going out there and meeting with the people. I just think that they want to be heard.
We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk with Chris Spears of Prestige Auto for the Friday Drive, and then we'll have the sheriff give us any upcoming events that he wants to let the public know about concerning the Marion County Sheriff's Office. We'll do it next on Ask the Cops, brought to you by Daniel L. Hodgeauer, lawyer fighting for accident victim justice since 1976. We'll be right back after this short timeout on The Source.
If you've been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and were worried because you couldn't get in, I've got some good news for you. Seating is now available. While you're there, look up Chef Dave Del Rio. He'll buy you a drink. Now is the time for you to finally see firsthand what your friends are talking about at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Check out those gorgeous Lakeware sunsets. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill on beautiful Lakeware. Seating now available.
Located next door to Silver Spring State Park and a few minutes from historic downtown Ocala, our award-winning Holiday Inn Express Hotel and Suites of Silver Springs is a place to stay for a friendly, memorable, and fun experience. Enjoy our fast and free Wi-Fi, complimentary hot breakfast, and free parking. Whether you're in town for work or play, our friendly staff will make you feel right at home. That's the Holiday Inn Express and Suites of Silver Springs, proud sponsor of Friday Night Marion County High School Football on WOCA. The Source.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
If you're anything like I was, the thought of getting older was the last thing on your mind. But here we are. For me, it started slowly. The lack of energy. Never being in the mood.
and when I was, I could never perform at my best. I tried the pills and other treatments with minimal results, and all but given up on my sex life. Then, I found the doctors at New Mayo Medical Center. Wow, they made a new male out of me. Feel like I'm 25 again. I have renewed vigor, so much more energy, and no longer worry about my performance. New Mayo treated me like my situation was one of a kind. With a custom treatment plan that really works, I feel great. They can create one for you too. It does not matter if you suffer from low testosterone, erectile dysfunction, or just want to last longer. New Mayo will help you.
Call New Mayo Medical Center today at 352-404-4779. 352-404-4779. That's 352-404-4779. It will change your life. 352-404-4779.
Don Nottingham with the Miami Dolphins here, proud to be this year's chairman at the Special Olympics Champions for Champions event. Come join players from the world of professional sports, sharing their stories with a great dinner on Friday, September 18th, and or play at Candler Hills Golf Club on Saturday, September 19th. Either way, you'll be helping the Special Olympics of Marion County Champions for Champions. Call 988-7998 for details. That's 988-7998. Please help our Special Olympians.
What you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Women are more likely to feel stressed at night than men, and here's why. Because even after working all day, women typically come home to chores and childcare, while men kick back with a beer and watch TV, right? The way we feel when we indulge in a forbidden food, like a Philly cheesesteak, has a major impact on our ability to stick with our diet. Pet ownership, it has been linked to less stress, lower blood pressure, and better heart health.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala on a Friday afternoon. That means it's time for the Friday Drive, brought to you by Prestige Auto. Chris Spears, the Yes Man, on the line with us. Chris, good afternoon. How's your day, sir?
Good, Tom. Thanks for calling in, man. Everything is great. Little wet right now, but that's okay. Cool things off. We're getting ready for a big weekend. We're, of course, always closed on Sunday, but we will be around all day tomorrow to serve your listeners, and then again on Monday for the big sales day event. But got a lot of nice cars. I've actually looked this morning. I've got purchased 42 new cars in the last 2 weeks to replace stuff that the guys sold. So they've been busy, and got a lot of fresh inventory. And his buddy tells me every week I buy nice cars, but not to keep.
Chris, now I know you help people that may not be able to be helped by some of the big box stores, and because of Beacon scores and everything. You don't look at that, but you're not just the guy that helps with those kind of situations. You got 2014 and 2015 cars out there that you can get good bank rates on, and you have those for sale as well.
Yes, sir. I don't have a 215 today, but I've got some 13s and 14s, and we've got the Wells Fargo and the Florida credit unions and the campuses, and so the 1.9 and 2.9 money that you see touted, we have that also. That's kind of a vanilla offering for the best credit customers, but it seems like and we certainly extend that to your listeners out there. They don't have to go anyplace else but Prestige. And and another thing is, I think, that gives us an advantage besides our finance options, because the dealership has two finances, I don't have layers and layers of management. When you walk in and the salesmen have to run talk to these guys behind the desk, and there's about six or eight of them back there, those guys are all $5,000-$10,000 a month guys, and coming to Prestige, you're gonna visit with me. So I think the layers that we don't have a $10 million facility to pay for and $8,000-$10,000 managers to pay for each month, I think that savings gets extended to your listeners and my customers.
Chris, if I have a car that I didn't get from you, but I want to make sure that it's in sound working condition, and I need to run it by, but I don't really have $150 to take it to a mechanic to look at it. Can I bring it to you, and will you give me it? Will you look at it for me for a pretty good price?
Yes, sir. And I don't offer that to just be able to rain on somebody else's parade. But if somebody wants a free Carfax and they don't want to pay $25 for one, or if they want somebody to look under the hood and listen to a noise and not pay a $65 inspection fee, You know, I just recently had a Mercedes serviced myself, and we shopped between Ocala and Gainesville for it. And when we asked what the labor rate was, it was $155 an hour. And I was just like, golly, just kind of makes me cringe. But, you know, if somebody needs a free look or something, we can provide our services. I'd certainly extend it to your listeners at no charge. Just if we can help in some way, we'd be happy to.
Chris Spears, Prestige Auto. Check him out on the internet at Prestige For You. That's Prestige, the number four, the letter U.com. Chris, have a great Labor Day weekend, and God bless.
Thank you, sir. And I want to thank Deputy Paul that's there and Chris Blair for all their great service for our county. Thank you so much, guys.
Thanks, sir. Appreciate it.
Our pleasure.
Chris Spears, Prestige Auto. Go check him out, the Yes Man. Now, Sheriff, earlier this morning, your office participated in something pretty special.
Yeah, we the National Sheriff Association basically endorsed a moment of silence on behalf of all the fallen heroes across the nation, our law enforcement family. So at the Marion County Sheriff's Office, we brought people together to actually say a prayer, and then we did a moment of silence for those fallen officers.
That's great to hear, but watch out saying those prayers. You know, the chief police is being sued right now for joining in on saying some prayers.
Well, you know, I think that we all know who we work for, and that's why we're here.
Without a doubt. Now, you found the date for your next town hall meeting.
Yeah, I actually did. You know, I had a lot of notes right here, so I did locate it, and the next one's at the Shrine Club on Southeast Maricamp Road. Everybody should know that's Southeast 17th Street, and also known as, I think it's 464 going out, Maricamp Road. And it's on October 15th at 6 p.m., so we welcome everyone in that community, that area, to attend, and I think that they will enjoy it.
What are some other things going on at the Sheriff's Department right now?
Well, let me look real here. We know we got Tip a Cop, which is our cancer event. You know, we come together and do our cancer stuff, trying to raise money for American cancer.
Is that the one where we may get you in a pink brassiere?
Well, you know, you never know what may happen, because they try to do everything they can to get me involved in things like that when we can raise money. So that one actually is scheduled. Let me look at the date here. It's for the 19th of September, and it's from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. We'll have officers there. Ocala Police Department will have officers there. And that's where we actually go out and we serve food, and the tips that we get actually go for American cancer. Actually, it's making strides. So it's a great program. You know, we finished first in the state in 2013, and we finished 13th in the country with the most money raised. So it's a good partnership with these agencies, Dunnell and PD, Bellevue, and the Ocala PD. So we look forward to it.
Deputy Paul Bloom, why I'm goofing on Bloom? I don't know. Paul, I hear talk all the time, and we got about a minute to go. I hear talk all the time of this obstacle course that he runs and y'all run and everything, and he keeps inviting me out to run this thing.
If you come, I'll run it with you.
I have no business running that thing, do I?
You will. Sure, you do.
I see you run it.
Yeah.
Will emergency medical technicians be on site?
We have AEDs on standby.
You would have to have AEDs every 5 or 6 yards.
But you're certainly welcome to come out.
I told the sheriff I'd run it. Well, come on, Hummer.
Yeah. Well, listen, I'm a paramedic also, so come on. You have no excuse.
You know, the sheriff told me if I come running on a regular basis, it would be very difficult. But the more I run it, the better I'd run it, because I definitely get in shape. There's no way you're not going to get in shape running that obstacle course. Now, my question, now, Deputy, he's not listening. He's what, looking at his notes.
No, I'm listening to you.
He's looking at his notes.
I'm thinking, you know, if we just have you walk it and then do the obstacles.
That might be an idea.
Maybe you should try that first.
Start there.
I'll do that with you.
Let me ask you a question. Is he as good as he says he is on the obstacle course? He's not listening. You can tell the truth.
His name was at the bottom of my last paycheck, so I'm going to say
good answer,
say yes,
there, Paul. Good
yes,
answer.
Tom.
See how that works, Chris?
You can believe how fast he is.
It's
out
all
there.
About signatures, isn't it, Chris? Yeah.
Well, you know, I do continue to run it because, you know, all of our senior staff run it. You know, it's an 8.5-minute course, and You know, I just tell you, there's a lot of good stories out there. We've saved lives. You know,
yeah.
The ones that went to get medical screens and medical exams found out that, you know, one of them had a clot, you know, and the doctor told him that to save his life. So we have others that have lost 30, 40, 50 pounds.
Wow.
They're out there working the obstacle course.
Well, as always, it goes by too fast, Sheriff. Deputy Bloom, thanks for being here, Sheriff. Thanks for being here. Ask the Cops, brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer. Fighting for accident victim justice. Stay tuned to a best of the Restaurant and Food Show.
Do you remember when summer was a celebration? You know, no schools, no worries, just days packed with your favorite pastime. It was the splendid season you dreamed of all year long. But as you got older and busier, the summer seemed to lose its sparkle. Where did those carefree days go? Well, they're closer than you think. Summer's still sensational at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club, where you can come out and play the grown-up way with our affordable summer memberships. Enjoy our championship golf course celebrating the game's greatest holes, hard-true tennis courts, and a state-of-the-art fitness center. Explore our stately 77,000-square-foot clubhouse and unwind at our relaxing spa.
Don't forget the pool!
It's a summer unlike any other, and it's yours with a Golden Ocala summer membership. You can call Golden Ocala at 629-6229 to inquire about a summer membership, or you can visit goldenocala.com to learn more. That's goldenocala.com.
When you were a kid, you had all sorts of toys. Toy cars, boats, trucks, entire toy boxes full of fun. Of course, you never really outgrow your toys, do you? It's just that now, instead of a box full, you have a garage full. Cars, trucks, boats, motorcycles, ATVs, and more. As you get older, your love of toys just gets stronger. So protect those toys the best way possible by switching to Allstate. An Allstate agent can help do the switching, paperwork, bundle all your policies together, and even find you a bunch of discounts. So if you love your toys, make sure you protect your toys by making one call to an Allstate agent.
Protect all your toys with Allstate and the McDonald Agency. Established in 1985, we have offices in Ocala and the Villages to better serve you. Give us a call at 622-2333. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability.
Are you in good hands?
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, "It's our business to make your business better." Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Big savings on carpet and vinyl right now at DIY. It's the big pre-Labor Day carpet and vinyl sale happening now through Saturday. Take an additional 15% off their already low outlet prices. On sale now, fiberglass pre-hung doors starting at only $119. Insulated fiberglass French doors, only $399. In stock and ready to be picked up. All wood kitchen cabinets in stock and ready to go. From all wood cabinets to granite vanity tops, DIY has you covered. Don't overpay at one of those big box stores. Put more money in your wallet and save big at DIY Home Center Outlet. Need tile, laminate flooring? DIY has it. Need those hard-to-find mobile home parts? Look no further than DIY Home Center Outlet. Tubs, showers, doors, and windows. It's all at DIY. Whether you're looking for savings on your mobile home or traditional home, DIY Home Center Outlet is the place to get great deals every day to save you money. Just a mile and a half east of I-75 on Highway 27 or DIYHomeCenterOutlet.com. And for new items and daily specials, check them out on Facebook. The DIY Home Center Outlet.
Robin, let's try a little plant trivia. Name this nursery. It's a not-for-profit, and it teaches growing and caring for plants to their students.
Oh, that's easy. Kenny's Place.
Or how about this one? It's a nursery conveniently located between Ocala and Bellevue.
Again, it's Kenny's Place.
Or how about this one? A nursery with a wide variety of just what you need or want at the most reasonable prices.
Kenny's Place, of course.
Kenny's Place at 7677 Southeast 41st Court. Give them a call at 867-1213. It's a caring place for people and plants. It's Kenny's Place.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Carol McHugh. The hunt for three suspected cop killers in Fox Lake, Illinois is being helped along by new surveillance video.
I think we're optimistic about all of these videos right now because they all come together chronologically. There are different cameras that are putting a storyline together.
Chief George Falenko, a $50,000 award's been posted for the capture and conviction of the killers of Lieutenant Joe Glenowitz. The attorney for Kentucky Clerk Kim Davis, jailed for refusing to issue gay marriage licenses over religious objections, says his client has no intention of stepping down. Labor Day motorists are seeing the lowest gas prices in more than a decade.
As of this morning, the average price across America for regular is $2.42 a gallon, which is a full buck less than it was at this time last year. AAA reporting the national average of a regular gallon of gas has fallen for 14 consecutive days.
Fox's Laura Engel, Fox News, we report, you decide.
Are you at risk of identity theft? Yes. A new identity theft happens every 2 seconds. Does giving out your social security number increase risk? Yes. Putting personal information out there increases risk. If you forget your significant other's birthday, are you at risk of getting the silent treatment? Probably. No one likes having their birthday forgotten. But it won't increase the risk of identity theft. Unfortunately, things like shopping and breaches will. That's why LifeLock goes beyond free services that simply monitor credit, from detecting threats to helping resolve issues if your identity is ever compromised. No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor all transactions at all businesses, but LifeLock has proprietary technology to detect threats and a dedicated resolution staff to help restore your good name. Is getting the silent treatment fun? No, but it's a walk in the park compared to having your identity stolen. Protection starts at $9.99 a month. For 10% off, go to lifelock.com and use promo code NEWS.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry. We didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on. Stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Welcome back to hour number two of The Voice of Ocala on a Tuesday afternoon. That means it's time for the restaurant and food show. Dave Del Rio, the chef at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. He's here as always. Good afternoon, Dave. How are you?
You know what? I couldn't be better. What a great day.
It's a perfect day. Sun's high in the sky. You know, and I like the warm temperature. So I love summers in Florida. And you love summers in Florida because that means the doors are open, the beach is open, the breeze is blowing through, and that's a good day at Eaton's Beach.
It's a good day. We're firing on all cylinders. We got the bass boats out there, and I might sneak out a little bit later on tonight, too, as a matter of fact. So.
Now, I heard something the other day. Somebody told me that and I wanted to ask you if this was right or not, that jet skis are available for rental at Eaton's Beach now?
Yes, yes, they are. We are renting jet skis there now.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That's great.
It's right now, it's on the weekends. And come up there. There's a number that you can call. And, of course, I'm going to have to find out what that number, because I don't remember off the top of my head.
Well, Susan always finds out the numbers for you.
She'll know what it is. but, yeah, we do them on the weekends, and it's been really fun. We've had a lot of people. They kind of go all the time.
Well, you know, I specifically go to Blue Gator in Dunellen.
Mm-hmm.
Not the food is adequate and everything. It's fuel, you know, mm-hmm. but I go there because you can rent jet skis or boats to get on the river. Now there's no reason to go there because I can rent jet skis at Lake Weir, so I just come out to Eaton's Beach all the time.
There you go. We got jet skis, you know, yeah.
Eaton's Beach is closer than Dunellen for me. I can just go right to Eaton's Beach now.
That's right. That's right. But, you know, I will say something, though. And not that I don't want you to come over there, but on that river, that's pretty cool.
That is nice. The river's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
The river's pretty cool over there.
You know what gets me is when you go, like, where it goes from the Withlacoochee to the Rainbow,
uh-huh.
that divider line where it's clear
and
dark,
and then murky. Oh, yeah.
How does that work?
And it's almost like they drew a straight line. It's right there.
That's what it looks like.
It goes from murky to straight to clear.
That's a mystery in my mind.
I don't know how, because, you know, you can go from, like, the St. John's River, you get eventually up high enough in St. John's River, you can start tasting the salt water when you get in the water and everything because of the brackish. You would think the murky and the clear would mix somehow, and they don't. It's almost like there's a barrier.
That's right.
It's like a black and tan, Tom.
Huh?
Black and tan.
It's like a black and tan. A Guinness.
No, because even with the black tan, sometimes it filters down into it a little bit.
You're right.
Yeah, well, I'm talking to a guy that used to pour Guinnesses correctly, so... Got a special guest in the studio today. Cindy Nicholson, not with us from Mark's Prime Seafood, Steak and Seafood, but we do have a special guest in, an actual TV star, if it was. Dave, why don't you tell us about that?
You know, I got to tell you, I'm really excited to have him here. He is, we haven't had a chance to catch up, but he doesn't know a lot about me yet, but I know about him. He's one of the nine finalists on the next Grilling Star, is that what it's called?
Search for America's New Grill Star.
He was just on with Kelly Ripa and Michael on Friday, and he's one of the finalists. And let me tell you something, he's got a really great burger there that I'm gonna have a few questions on, because I'm also of a Hispanic background. So I looked at it over, and I was like, oh, that sounds really good. So anyway, let's welcome Jose Juarez, local guy. Doing great.
Now, thanks for being here, Jose. Good to have you.
Hey, thanks for having me here.
Now, where are you a chef at?
I am not a chef. I'm a chef at 636 Southeast 45th Terrace, my house. So, to me, it's a hobby. I come home from work, and one of the things I love doing is I love creating. I love cooking on the grill. It's a way to relax, and that's basically my grill is on. I'd have to say 6 out of 7 days. I might be 7, but
well,
at least
you just
6.
You just said on, so I you already cleared up one question for me, because you know, in the grilling world,
mm-hmm.
you're either charcoal or you're gas. You're one or the other. And what are you? I get your gas because you said the grill's on.
I'm both.
Are you both?
I've got 5 grills.
Wow. 5 grills.
So, yeah. So it's not, I'm not a one grill guy. I do have a 5 burner gas. And then in the office, I have a 3 burner gas because I cook there for our office staff at Victory Solutions. And then I have something called a cajachina, which is charcoal. It's basically. And then I have 2 smokers, which on the end of them, they also have a charcoal grill. So I'm diverse in the grill world.
My dad, when I was growing up, I started grilling when I was a young kid because my dad was an auto mechanic, but he would host Sunday parties. We'd get home from Catholic Church Sunday morning because he was an 8 o'clock Mass guy, so because he wasn't going to miss the NFL, so he's 8 o'clock Mass guy. We'd get home about 9:15, 9:20, and he would go out and he'd start the grill up. And when I say grill, my dad took 3 55-gallon drums and welded them together the whole length.
That's yeah.
And he had it where it cut, and he had a grill, you know, it's probably 6.5 foot long grill that he was sat down in there. And he would put the, he would take the charcoal and put from one end, use like 6 bags of charcoal, and he would put it from one end to the other. And we had this old garbage can sitting over there that was full of water with a lid on it. He would take those bourbon-soaked chips out of that water he'd been soaking and throw those on there, and he would cook for 40, 50 people every Sunday. So I, as soon as I was older, he didn't want me working on cars because he was a mechanic and he didn't want me to bust my knuckles. But as soon as I was old enough to belly up to that grill, he was showing me spatulas and how heat worked and everything. So grilling is the one thing that I really look forward to. And I, 5 grills, Dave.
You know, that's something. That's more than I got. I got to admit, you know, 5 grills.
Now, you, I would think this is something you do almost every weekend.
Oh yeah, I mean, I'm telling you, it's every night. You know, a lot of times, my neighbors and you know, like one of my neighbors, Randy Buss, he becomes my test kitchen because, I'll call him at 11 o'clock at night. You know, sometimes, and I'll just sit there. You know, I'm Cuban. I eat late, so it's one of those things where you know, I'll call him up and say, hey, I just came up with something. But every piece of equipment kind of has its job. The cajachina, that's for a whole pig, you know, and I've done that on a couple occasions. I've got a smoker for fish because I don't like to mix it in because the fish is so strong. If you mix that smoker, it doesn't work. I've got another one for all kinds of other meats, you know, and then, of course, the gas grill.
The gas grills, and that's something else. You said you got a grill just for cooking the whole hog,
yep.
Where I cook a whole hog by digging a hole in the ground.
Yep,
that's how I do it.
You know, kind of the same principle with cajachina.
It is.
Is it really?
Cajachina means Chinese box.
Oh, okay, so it's just a hot box.
So yeah, I mean it's real similar kind of process, but I'm gonna tell you something. They work great. I've cooked many a pig in a cajachina.
I get friends of mine say, "You dig a hole? What?" I'm South Georgia. We dig a hole and cook a hog in a hole.
South Florida, same. I mean, every Christmas growing up as a kid, we would have the whole hog and we would dig the hole.
Right.
And, you know, there's different ways of doing it. I personally haven't done that. But, you know, years ago, a good friend of mine, John McLeod, actually gave me the cajachina, you know. And then from there, I just started.
City Councilman John McLeod?
Yeah, yeah. So
you just publicly said he's a good friend of yours?
Oh,
he is. I would retract that. I'd retract that quick.
He's a great friend.
Wait. He's probably fixing to text me and go, watch it, Mr. Schmitz. I actually talked to your good friend John McLeod this morning. He called me this morning. I was watching Game of Thrones. He interrupted me watching Game of Thrones, the guy.
Well, I've known John for over 20 years, and you know, he said, I want a good Cuban to give this to, and which was great because it went to good use, and we've cooked lots of hogs in that bad boy.
We're gonna take a break. When we come back, Chef Dave Del Rio will start quizzing Jose Juarez on exactly what it was he cooked for Kelly and Michael that made him a semifinalist.
Inquiring minds want to know.
Next on the Restaurant and Food Show, right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Do you remember when summer was a celebration? You know, no schools, no worries, just days packed with your favorite pastime. It was the splendid season you dreamed of all year long. But as you got older and busier, the summer seemed to lose its sparkle. Where did those carefree days go? Well, they're closer than you think. Summer's still sensational at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club, where you can come out and play the grown-up way with our affordable summer memberships. Enjoy our championship golf course celebrating the game's greatest holes, hard-true tennis courts, and a state-of-the-art fitness center. Explore our stately 77,000-square-foot clubhouse and unwind at our relaxing spa.
Don't forget the pool!
It's a summer unlike any other, and it's yours with a Golden Ocala summer membership. You can call Golden Ocala at 629-6229 to inquire about a summer membership, or you can visit goldenocala.com to learn more. That's goldenocala.com.
Central Florida is well known for our love of horses, and here at Seminole Fence Company, we have over 20 years of experience in providing quality fence products and services for farm and residential properties. Let us surround your property with a fence that provides privacy, security, and of course, stunning appeal. Don't wait. Contact us today at 352-208-0959 for a free estimate. Seminole Fence Company, working hard to build fences, working harder to build relationships.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75, exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt golf, and a car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. It'll be partly sunny today with a thunderstorm around during the afternoon hours, high 90 to 94. Tonight, partly cloudy. There can be a thunderstorm in spots near the coast early on, those 73 to 77. Tomorrow, partly sunny. Watch out for an afternoon thunderstorm, high 89 to 93. Thursday, sunshine mixing with clouds with a couple of thunderstorms around, mainly during the afternoon hours, the high 88 to 92. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
If you're anything like I was, the thought of getting older was the last thing on your mind. But here we are. For me, it started slowly. The lack of energy. Never being in the mood. And when I was, I could never perform at my best. I tried the pills and other treatments with minimal results, and all but given up on my sex life. Then, I found the doctors at New Mayo Medical Center. Wow, they made a new male out of me. Feel like I'm 25 again. I have renewed vigor, so much more energy, and no longer worry about my performance. New Mayo treated me like my situation was one of a kind. With a custom treatment plan that really works, I feel great. They can create one for you too. It does not matter if you suffer from low testosterone, erectile dysfunction, or just want to last longer. New Mayo will help you.
Call New Mayo Medical Center today at 352-404-4779. 352-404-4779. That's 352-404-4779. It will change your life. 352-404-4779.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back to the Restaurant and Food Show here on the Voice of Ocala. Every Tuesday with Chef Dave Del Rio, the co-host, although Buddy's not here today. He is at SEC Media Days in Hoover, Alabama. He'll be checking in after the next break with us. But Chef Del Rio is here from Eat the Beat Sandbar and Grill. And Chef, I turn it over to you. It's time to find out about this Cuban burger.
I'm going to grill this guy.
Oh boy.
Oh.
Okay. So you really are an amateur at this, right?
Absolutely, 100%.
Okay. How did you get involved in this Kelly and Michael deal?
I'm a fan of the show, you know, and I do watch the show. You know, with my business, we deal with motorcycle dealers across the country. So I usually get in around 10 o'clock, and then I'll stay till 8, 9 o'clock. So I'm kind of the night shift there. And so I'll watch the show at 9 o'clock, and they had this contest going on, America's Next Grill Star. And it sounded interesting, but honestly, I would have never done it if it wasn't for my wife, Kelly, where she was like, hey, you need to do this. And I was like hawing around. And, you know, and then finally she kind of drove me to the point where the rule was a 30-second video you had to send them on basically your story, what your sandwich is, and you know, what you make. So I sent that to them. Nice. And, you know.
It just took off from there, huh?
Well, I sent it to him, and I got contacted probably 7 days or 5 days afterwards with a few questions, a few more questions, you know. And then from there, they basically, you know, I got notified in a very short notice that I was a number six semifinalist, and they flew Kelly and I up to New York.
Oh, cool.
Put us up at a hotel, had a driver. It was kind of like, I call it like a Cinderella thing. You know, it's kind of funny. You're at the airport, you got your limo, you got your driver taking you to the hotel, and, mm-hmm. you know, when you leave, the same thing, and then you end up in Orlando, pick up your car in a rainstorm. You know, I was looking to see if my shoe was missing.
Back to reality, you know? Yeah.
Well, now, it says August 14th, two finalists are going to compete.
Right.
In front of judges, and this is pretty good swag they get. The winner's going to get $10,000, star in 5 webisodes of live on the live website and AOL.com. Runner up though gets $2,500. So
that ain't a bad day.
It's not a bad day.
Ain't a bad day.
A sharp stick in the eye, right? Yeah,
For sitting out. Now here's the big question: the Cuban burger,
right?
Well, now I got a question. Now you used to do R&D. You know, research and development, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And I've had recipes that, you know, or ideas that I've been sitting on for years.
Right.
So is this one that just came to you, or have you been sitting on this for a long time?
No, this one is one that basically came to me. It's nothing I've been sitting on. I don't really sit on stuff because I'm not a professional like yourself. You know, so I don't look at, I'm going to do this later, whatever. I'm always playing with different flavors and different ideas. And, you know, and I've done a lot of, you know, pulled pork. I use a fresh ham, what I call a picnic ham.
Sure.
And, you know, so kind of like when I was thinking about what am I going to send him? It's a bit complex, but I did not want to just go up there and do something simple. I wanted something that was going to be complex, something that was going to have a lot of flavors. And I really thought, I want to marry, you know, something that's classic in the United States, the hamburger, and then something that's classic in Cuba, the Cuban sandwich, and then put them together. And some of the twists on it is that you know, the pulled pork on it is actually smoked. But then it sits in mojo for 4 hours before in the oven, and then it gets smoked for 4 hours. So when you bite into that top part, you've got a smokiness, and then you've got that citrus mojo along with my burger. It's not an ordinary burger. I do a ribeye steak. I go to my butcher and basically tell him to grind it up as hamburger. So now I've got a medium rare ribeye steak burger. You know, I've got my pickles, which I put on the grill. Then on top of that, I've got my sweet sliced ham, Swiss cheese, and then I'm putting my pulled pork on top. And then, of course, you can't forget my 455 sauce. You know, that gets drizzled on top of it. And then
why do you call it the 455 sauce? I love this.
Well, the 455, you know, I love muscle cars. You know, since I was a kid, I was a huge Pontiac fan. You know, I can still remember the first time coming to the United States from Cuba. The first car I ever saw on the street that just impressed me was a 69 GTO Judge. Been a huge fan of Pontiacs.
It's a great car.
I got goosebumps.
It's a great car.
I'm telling you.
I have a 71 GTO convertible that was always my dream to have a GTO. When Kelly and I were dating, I had that car back in school, so I've owned it over 30 years. So the engine in it is a 455. I kind of, as I was working up the sauce, one of the things that they had to have for the show, they said, we need exact measurements. I'm a guy that puts stuff together and throws it in there. So I had to start measuring it, and it came out to, you know, exact 4 parts, which was the you know, combination of the 4 tablespoons of mojo, 5 tablespoons of mustard, 5 tablespoons of mayo. Mix it again. There you got 455.
Couldn't have planned that.
No.
You know? Couldn't have made that up.
So it worked nice. I tell people, I was almost a 442, but I kept having to add a couple things. And then, you know, I told Michael that on the show, and he was funny. If he catch it, he looks over, he goes, that's an Olds. So he was into muscle cars.
That's right,
yeah.
That's right. So, okay, so what kind of bread does it have?
Cuban bread.
It is on Cuban bread.
It's on Cuban bread. So think about it. Traditionally, you got your Cuban bread. I put a little bit of that 455 sauce on the bottom of it. It gets toasted first, just slightly on the grill. Then the next layer is your Swiss cheese, and then you have your steak burger, and then you have your pickles, and then I take the sweet sliced ham, just put it on the grill just a little bit, a couple grill marks, you know, so it's not cold, a little crispy. It goes on top. My pulled pork, drizzle the 455 sauce. sauce, a couple more slices of Swiss cheese, put the top on it, and press it. My press was a little unique. It's funny, when I was on the show, you know, they asked me, they said, what is that? I said, it's a piston. And you know, and they were like, we know it's a piston. What's it here for? I said, I'm pressing my sandwich with it.
That's great. That's great.
That, wow. You know, he's got ribeye ground up for the burger, pulled pork, which is a picnic ham. He's got all these great ingredients. And you know me, Dave, I love food. I'm thinking about all that food, and then he goes, 455 sauce, and explains that. Now all I can think about is when I was a kid, Mr. Britt 67 GTO that used to sit in his yard in a convertible. That's all I can think about now. I remember I wanted that GTO so bad. It was a 67 convertible GTO with a long body.
Nice car.
I wanted it so bad. I really wanted it. Now, so I've already lost track of thought on this food on the sandwich because I'm thinking GTOs.
Yeah, well, I'm still thinking about that sandwich, though. You know.
So You it's an infusion of the traditional Cuban sandwich with an American burger, and I bet Michael probably thought that it was one of the best things he'd ever eaten.
Oh yeah, he loved it. I mean, they're very gracious, both of them. But I really, you know, and you, if you guys watched it, and you did, you know,
I watch the show every day. It's one of my favorite shows.
Me too. I mean, and he, yeah, he loved the sandwich. She did too. And it was kind of funny because, the executive producer Gilman, he comes down, and at the very end, when I did my final thing, that's when he tried some of the pork, and then he ended up going back up, which I hadn't seen that at that point. Mm-hmm. And was telling, you know, right. That's when Kelly was saying, wow, what was it that she said? I'm trying to remember.
I forget the exact quote, but
I wanted to lick you or right. Something.
Oh, yeah. I don't want to say that, yeah. Something about, let's say, yeah.
Yeah, she, because usually when they get done with the food stuff, they go into some, but she made a point to say that she wanted to taste him again.
Something like that, yeah, because he smelled like barbecue.
And she had to be talking about that. She was stumbling around about that for at least a minute or so, yeah, you know.
So.
But the experience in New York, talk about that experience. You said it's kind of like Cinderella, but
yeah.
was it there and gone in a flash?
No, I mean, you know, we got there, it was a couple days. That day went by extremely fast over those few hours in the morning. But, you know, I mean, it was first class all the way. They flew my wife and I up and, you know, had a driver at the airport, put us up in a hotel. Interesting thing about it is, you know, literally a few hours before, I get called and they were like, we want you to make the pork yourself. Can you do that? Freeze it and bring it up here. So I did. So, you know, here I am on Broadway with some pork heading over to the studio. some frozen
probably
pork,
not but. The probably not the weirdest thing New Yorkers are going to see.
You're probably right.
So, got to take a break. Coming up after the break, Buddy Martin will join us from Hoover, Alabama. He'll give us an update on Coach Steve Spurrier, and we'll find out more from Jose Juarez. Just about really what we're going to ask is when we come over Saturday to get this burger, Dave.
I was wondering about that. I'm surprised he didn't have one with him. I guess I should have asked.
We already have the address because he gave the address. So, you know, we already know where he lives.
Oh, and a couple hundred of our closest friends, right?
People probably missed that, but I got it on tape. We can go back and listen, Dave. We can GPS it. It'll be great. Because he says... 11 o'clock at night, he's grilling.
That's right.
Just look for the smoke.
It works in my schedule.
Yeah, works with your schedule. Exactly.
Yeah,
11
exactly.
o'clock at night works for your schedule. More coming up next with Jose Juarez, who is a finalist on the Live with Kelly and Michael search for America's new grill star. I think he just needs to contact the people in Orlando at the Food Network, Dave, and go ahead and get his own show.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Coming up next. Buddy Martin joins us live from Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, and then more Restaurant and Food Show right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Mm-hmm. Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75 exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt, golf, and a car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name. If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, "It's our business to make your business better." Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Fox News Radio, I'm Carol McHugh. The hunt for three suspected cop killers in Fox Lake, Illinois is being helped along by new surveillance video.
I think we're optimistic about all of these videos right now because they all come together chronologically. There are different cameras that are putting a storyline together.
Chief George Falenko, a $50,000 award's been posted for the capture and conviction of the killers of Lieutenant Joe Glenowitz. The attorney for Kentucky clerk Kim Davis, jailed for refusing to issue gay marriage licenses over religious objections, says his client has no intention of stepping down. Labor Day motorists are seeing the lowest gas prices in more than a decade.
As of this morning, the average price across America for regular is $2.42 a gallon, which is a full buck less than it was at this time last year. AAA reporting the national average of a regular gallon of gas has fallen for 14 consecutive days.
Fox's Laura Ingle, Fox News. We report, you decide.
Are you at risk of identity theft? Yes. A new identity theft happens every 2 seconds. Does giving out your social security number increase risk? Yes. Putting personal information out there increases risk. If you forget your significant other's birthday, are you at risk of getting the silent treatment? Probably. No one likes having their birthday forgotten. But it won't increase the risk of identity theft. Unfortunately, things like shopping and breaches will. That's why LifeLock goes beyond free services that simply monitor credit, from detecting threats to helping resolve issues if your identity is ever compromised. No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor all transactions at all businesses, but LifeLock has proprietary technology to detect threats and a dedicated resolution staff to help restore your good name. Is getting the silent treatment fun? No, but it's a walk in the park compared to having your identity stolen. Protection starts at $9.99 a month. For 10% off, go to LifeLock.com and use promo code NEWS.
If you're anything like I was, the thought of getting older was the last thing on your mind. But here we are. For me, it started slowly. The lack of energy. Never being in the mood. And when I was, I could never perform at my best. I tried the pills and other treatments with minimal results, and all but given up on my sex life. Then, I found the doctors at New Mayo Medical Center. Wow, they made a new male out of me. Feel like I'm 25 again. I have renewed vigor, so much more energy, and no longer worry about my performance. New Mayo treated me like my situation was one of a kind. With a custom treatment plan that really works, I feel great. They can create
create one for you too. It does not matter if you suffer from low testosterone, erectile dysfunction, or just want to last longer. New Male will help you.
Call New Male Medical Center today at 352-404-4779. 352-404-4779. That's 352-404-4779. It will change your life. 352-404-4779.
Big savings on carpet and vinyl right now at DIY. It's the big pre-Labor Day carpet and vinyl sale happening now through Saturday. Take an additional 15% off their already low outlet prices. On sale now, fiberglass pre-hung doors starting at only $119. Insulated fiberglass French doors, only $399. In stock and ready to be picked up. All wood kitchen cabinets in stock and ready to go. From all wood cabinets to granite vanity tops, DIY has you covered. Don't overpay at one of those big box stores. Put more money in your wallet and save big at DIY Home Center Outlet. Need tile, laminate flooring? DIY has it. Need those hard-to-find mobile home parts? Look no further than DIY Home Center Outlet. Tubs, showers, doors, and windows. It's all at DIY. Whether you're looking for savings on your mobile home or traditional home, DIY Home Center Outlet is the place to get great deals every day to save you money. Just a mile and a half east of I-75 on Highway 27 or DIYHomeCenterOutlet.com. And for new items and daily specials, check them out on Facebook. The DIY Home Center Outlet.
Voicemail Cali, the restaurant and food show. We're going to take a break for just for a minute from talking with Jose Juarez and Chef Dave Del Rio and go out to the hotline to Hoover, Alabama. If y'all want to put those headsets on, you can hear Buddy there a little better. Go out to Hoover, Alabama and talk to Buddy Martin live at SEC Media Days. Buddy, you got Chef Dave Del Rio and one of the semifinalists for Kelly and Michael's Next Grilling Star, America's Next Grilling Star, Jose Juarez on the line with you. What's going on up in Hoover?
Excuse me, Tom. I'm just finishing up my strawberry tart here. Okay. In honor of Dave, I had to go ahead and finish that up there. But, yeah. Hi, well, this busy day, good day. Any day we get the head ball coach, it's always good. People are all a Twitter. Speaking of a Twitter, I guess Spurrier left here and immediately went to back to the airport and stopped at Arby's. There's a picture of him at Arby's on the way out of town for media days. But he had a big day today. I told somebody earlier, I'm going to be on with Paul Feinbaum at 6 o'clock tonight on the SEC Network, talk about Steve. I told somebody, I said, when you have a transcript and you can get 3 stars on items, pretty good transcript. I have 8. And some of the things he said today wasn't even the best he's ever been here, but here's one you have to love. How's it for an answer when they ask him why he was still coaching as a head coach after 26 years? He said, well, I forgot to get fired, and I'm not going to cheat.
I forgot to get fired and not going to cheat. Now, I was told to ask you today because I ran into Coach Ron Zook at Gateway Bank today. Coach Zook is in town in Ocala, and I said, I said, you were up at SEC Media Days. He said, well, ask him if the head ball coach is walking around with the swagger like he's really bragging on his football team, or is he a little subdued? Because that's the difference between a good team and a team with some work to be done. So how would you take the head ball coach today?
I don't know if swagger would be the right word. He's like he always was. He's full feisty. He has some good answers. But he did say things that you never heard him say before, like how much he appreciates the 7-6 record. And talking about teams like Texas A&M going 8-5, and was Auburn, they go, he said, 8-5 is not too bad in the SEC. And he says, I'm going to stick up to the SEC. People ask him about the SEC, he's been down. He said, we were 5-0 in our bowl games last year. And he said, so I'll tell you something else. Now, this is only way, Spurrier is the only guy I know who can be a spin doctor without actually spinning. Here's what puzzles me. And that is that he said today he's the youngest coach in the SEC to ever win 4 straight bowl games. Okay? You with me?
I'm with
you. It'll be this. Okay? Now you know how old he is, right?
Yes.
70.
Right.
He also happens to be the oldest coach ever coaching in the SEC. We looked it up today. Bear Bryant was 69 when he quit. So how could this be possible? He's the only coach to win four straight bowl games in the SEC.
Coach Spurrier at his best.
Yeah. I'm not going to take up the time, ladies and gentlemen. Dave, thanks for being there and your guest. Appreciate that very much. I just want to say thanks to our fine sponsors if I can. Of course, ATG Hotels, great people, the supporters of all things sports, high school sports in our county, and as well as CF Basketball. Randy Briggs, who's been very part of our program for a long time, the Briggs Law Firm, Randy and Bo, appreciate that, for helping us make this trip to up here possible. I'll talk to you again at 5:15 today, and at 6 o'clock, if you're around I guess it's on TV, but it's a radio show, Paul Feinbaum, I'll be on with Paul on the SEC Network at 6 o'clock.
Yeah, I've already DVR'd something out, so just so you know, I've already DVR'd something.
You've heard all my stuff anyway. Dave, hope you're doing well. He's not abusing you, is he, Dave?
No, we're great. We're doing great.
All right, well, great, and thank you for coming in today and putting the show together. Thanks to your guests, too. I'll get out of here and let you guys talk food.
Thank you, buddy.
Have fun.
Buddy Martin, live from SEC Media Days. So, you know, your burger would probably have went over well up at SEC Media Days.
Oh, I think so.
You go up there and cook the Cuban burger for him up there.
Yeah, I can't imagine anywhere where it wouldn't work, you know.
Now, let me ask you, when you go, because you're going to go back, you're going to be one of the two finalists, okay? We're just going to go ahead and we're going to make that happen. Mm-hmm. By the way, how is this voting taking place to derive the two finalists?
Well, you got to get on, it's all social media, Facebook. So you get on, basically, if you've got Facebook, go up to the top and hit Live with Kelly and Michael Show. Live Kelly and Michael Show. It'll pop up and then go directly to their Facebook, view basically my two videos. You got to like them and then you got to share them.
So you got to like it and share it.
Yeah, you get points for viewing, liking, and sharing. You know, I was pretty pumped up because I've got somewhere around 84,000 views so far.
You've got 1.8 million likes so far.
His video has 1.8 million
Holy
likes.
Holy cow.
Is that that many?
Wow.
That's more than two or three.
It's a lot of burgers.
I have to get this guy to come over on to the restaurant. We have to feature that hamburger one day or something, you know?
Wow. We're going to his house Saturday. I know where that house is, near the neighborhood that house is located in. I play a lot of golf in that general area.
I gotcha. But, you know, the timing of a sandwich like that, you know how I always talk about classics?
Yeah.
And comfort food. Come on, the timing. You know, it's hot. It's what I mean by hot is I mean it's you know, it's popular. People are learning about the Cuban sandwich, and to marry it with a classic like a burger it can only be a winner. It really can.
Well, Cuba and relations with America have been such in the news right now here lately. With the opening back up of flights. I mean, last week in Orlando, all the news channels sent reporters on the first chartered flights to Cuba back to see what's going on. So it's really in the news, but it's a food that that's one of the reasons I love being from Florida is the Cuban influence of food. I'm a huge fan. I got a friend of mine that they make a Cuban sandwich, and it's a big production where it's a piece of bread he bakes. It's like this long, and when I'm doing this, I'm showing you about a yard long, and he cuts it into slices and presses it and everything. And he invites everybody over, and it's like a gathering and a party for him to make this Cuban for everybody. And that says a lot about the Cuban culture. Is every time I've been around my friends that are of Cuban descent, it's never just a couple people over. It's a party when you're over there grilling out and having food. Oh, yeah. And that's what this burger sounds like. It would be a great addition to one of those parties.
And it's never subdued. The parties are never quiet.
Yeah, no, we're very loud.
Yeah.
I think that may have something to do with the whole Latin thing, because Italians, we're very loud as well.
Exactly. Yeah, I had a buddy of mine going, I saw you on TV. Are you sure you're not Italian because you're moving your hands around a lot? I said, you know, we're a lot alike. So
now, Facebook, like the video and share the video. two finalists go back to now. Are you going to make the same? Will you remake the same thing in New York?
You know, I have no idea what happens when you get to that next step. I know that two go back. I don't know if you make the same thing or you have to come up with something else, you know, but we still got 30 days to figure that out if I'm one of the fortunate ones to be
But you
chosen.
Don't have 30 days to vote.
No, you've got till tomorrow at 4 o'clock to vote, you know. And
tomorrow, 4 p.m.
Tomorrow 4 o'clock. Everybody get your votes in.
4 p.m. Eastern.
Yeah.
Eastern.
So yeah, you gotta Google that, you know, as far as live with Kelly and Michael on and get on their Facebook, view it, share it. You get points for how many people viewed it, how many people shared it.
Luke,
you know,
Luke, we're posting that on the Buddy Martin Voice of Ocala Facebook page right now, so we'll let everybody know out there. And you know, I think we ought to share. I'm gonna post it on my page, and then I'm gonna put it on some groups that I'm a member of because
cool.
I need all the support. I know a bunch of groups that, you know, word of mouth and all kind of places we can put that. So now, when we talk recipes, we've talked about this one, the Cuban burger, but sounds like to me, you got quite a Rolodex of them, but now are the recipes in the Rolodex of the mind, or do you have them written down somewhere?
No, it's all in my it's all in my mind. I make I make my own barbecue sauce, and that really started off. And a lot of the stuff like this, I'm going to start making my own mojo. I've been buying it, but I decided now I'm going to make it. And the barbecue sauce turned into the same kind of thing. It was add a little bit of this. It's always got bourbon in it. It's always got brown sugar in it. You know, I make a chili that I use instead of red beans. I use black beans, and all of the meats are smoked first. So and it's got pork tenderloin. It's got beef tenderloin. My hamburger, I put it on the smoker and grind it up. My Italian sausage, it goes on the smoker. So when this chili comes out, it's hot, it's smoky, you know, it's just different things. I got, you know, I don't know, I've got ribs that I you know, that I make a little bit different. You know, they're infused with a combination of mojo, and you know, so you get that my hot sweet barbecue sauce on top, kind of a crunchy top. You get in the middle of it, you got mojo. So you basically have a sweet and sour rib that's been smoked.
Dave, correct me if I'm wrong. I've been in restaurant business quite a while. You're a chef. There's a whole lot of complexity in everything he's talking about here. There's a lot of flavors going on.
And that's what makes it so good, because you're right. There's a lot of flavors going on. Just the flavors of mojo, you know, the onion, the garlic, the citrus, the all the different things that go into that. You know what I mean? Just that is an explosion of flavor. So, yeah, you know, I'm excited to try it. And
Saturday, Dave.
Saturday.
I'm out of town this Saturday, but
you know, that took him a long time to finally figure out how to quell Saturday. Right?
But he got it. He got it in.
Hey, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll wrap up the restaurant and food show. Find out what's going on at Eaton's Beach. It's summertime, so I'm sure there's a lot going on at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. More with Chef Dave Del Rio and Jose Juarez. Did I say that right?
You got it.
Got it right. A finalist for America's Next Grilling Star on Kelly and Michael. You're listening to it on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Your quality of life is meant to be fully enjoyed each day. The doctors at Ayers Global understand that and strive to provide a quality of life for you that has no equal. Ayers Therapeutic Services combines naturopathic and family medicine to help all your health needs. Diabetic management, hypertension, pain management, and anti-aging are just a few of the services offered by the Ayers family. Call 352-512-0222 today, and Ayers Therapeutic Services will help you begin to understand that better health begins with you.
Are you one of those golfers that use the dot-coms to try to find the best deal available every day of the week? Well, why use a middleman? For $100, you can be a summer member at Pine Oaks of Ocala. And what do you get with your Pine Oaks membership? Well, you get to play all the golf that you want in the afternoons, and all you do is pay the cart fee. $8 for 9 holes or $12 for 18 holes. This is the golf deal of the summer. Don't miss it. That's the $100 summer membership at Pine Oaks of Ocala.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWCE.com. Safe boating is no accident. Mostly clear for tonight, lows 71 to 73. For tomorrow, clouds and sunshine with a shower or thunderstorm, high 88 to 92. Tomorrow night, cloudy, low 71 to 75. Thursday, thunderstorms, high 89 to 91. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Andy Robb.
Are you wasting hundreds or thousands of dollars on termite retreat fees? If you're not with Turner Pest Control, you probably are. Turner Pest Control offers the industry's only termite and pest control package that never charges retreat fees, ever. You can get started today for only $99. This is a value of $500 or more. This includes treatments, installation of monitoring stations, quarterly pest control, and a lifetime guarantee. All for an unbelievable low $99. Even if you have another pest control provider, visit TurnerPest.com to find out how you can avoid paying those high termite retreat fees.
Of custom screen printing, embroidery, or promotional items? Then look no further and come visit the brand new Legacy Team Sales. LTS is conveniently located off 17th Street next to Armstrong Homes in beautiful Ocala. We offer the best prices and highest quality products for your company, team, school, or nonprofit. Whether looking for screen printed shirts, embroidered polos, or travel team uniforms, you'll be sure to find it at Legacy Team Sales. Come visit our new 27,000 square foot facility. Our friendly and knowledgeable sales staff will assist you in every part of your custom purchase. LTS carries the hottest brands in the industry like Under Armour, Russell, Mizuno, Asics, Badger Sports, Gildan, Pacific, OGIO, and many more. At LTS, screen printing embroidery is done in-house and we guarantee customer satisfaction. Stop by, give us a call, or check us out on the web at shoplts.com. Remember the name, LTS.
Right here in the middle of the summer, it's time to talk some football. Follow me to Hoover, Alabama for SEC Media Days, made possible by the Briggs Law Firm, by HDG Hotels, and our thanks to Ocala Copy Center. It's football time, Hoover, Alabama, SEC Media Days.
Welcome back as we wrap up the restaurant and food show here on a Tuesday afternoon. The clouds are starting to roll in. That afternoon thunderstorm looked like it's building. Speaking of building, I just found the video with you with a blue-haired Kelly and Michael. And,
yeah, she looked great, didn't she?
You got quite the spread out there and everything. We've already shared it on the Buddy Martin Voice of Ocala Facebook page. So if you want to go out and help Jose Juarez out to become the next American Grill Master, you American Grilling Star.
Grill Star, yes.
Yeah, Grilling Star. You go and like and share it, and you get enough. It's, I'm looking at this now. The views on this page, I don't know how many likes and shares I hadn't got, it don't pan down, but the views are 35,576 that watched your 5 minutes.
Yeah, and then they have two videos, so you, if every time you look at each one, I think both of them combined were, you know, higher, 85,000, 84,000, something like that. But
so go out and help Jose bring the Grill Star Championship to Ocala.
Hey, you know what I just thought? Maybe he'll have me on his show.
There you go.
After he wins.
Dave, we got about 2 minutes. What's going on out at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill? We just got through with July 4th. I know that was a big success for you.
Yeah.
But what do we got? It's July. This weekend will be the 20th or something like that, the 5th, 19th, something like that.
Yeah.
What do you got coming up late in July and going into August?
Well, you know, where I'm working on some new stuff for downstairs. We still have our live music on Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays, which is, you know, we've got some great acts there, and that's been really, really a lot of fun. You know, we're kind of business as usual for the moment. You know, we're waiting on what's the next one, Labor Day, and, you know, to come up, but we're building something special for that. But I'm working on some food, you know, so get
and
ready
call,
for that.
And call. Because you got jet skis now, too. So make
that's
sure
right.
You
make sure. And you know what? The jet skis, that's a lot of fun. That's really added a lot. You know what we've got on the beach now, too? We've got life-size Jenga. How cool is that?
Life-size Jenga.
Yeah, they're huge. They're like 2x4s, and it is so much fun to play that.
I gotta come play that.
I'm telling you, it's a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite spots.
Oh, well, I appreciate that. Yeah. You know, we have a good time.
it is a fun. It's a fun time. I'm particularly. I like the golf cart ride from the parking lot down and back up. But that's just
Mr. Ben.
Mr. Ben. I like. I'm just.
He's a great guy.
Jose Juarez, thanks so much for stopping by the show today.
Thanks
good
for having
luck,
me.
Good luck to you in the competition, Dave Del Rio. As always, thanks to Susan for bringing you. Because without Susan, you wouldn't be here.
That's right.
But
that's right.
Thanks for all you bring to the show. Make sure you get out to Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. See what they got going on out there.
See me.
Upstairs, downstairs, out on the beach. Always activity going out there during the summer. Also, check out Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood on the square in beautiful downtown Ocala for all your fine dining needs. Coming up next, Buddy Sports Page. Buddy will check back in from SEC Media Days right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Hello, everybody. This is Terry Bradshaw reminding you to listen to Buddy Martin's Sports Page weekdays at 5 p.m. right here on The Source.
WWWWOCA. WOCA.
Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlitz Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue, proud sponsor of Marion County High School Football.
Whenever you're searching for an attorney, you want somebody with knowledge who has a commitment to our community and our state, such as the case with Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, in everything from car and other motor vehicle accidents, work accidents, personal injury, and wrongful death cases. Daniel L. Hightower also handles Social Security disability and bankruptcy. Call him today at 352-629-7777 or check out danhightower.com. Daniel L. Hightower, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Your quality of life is meant to be fully enjoyed each day. The doctors at Ayers Global understand that and strive to provide a quality of life for you that has no equal. Ayers Therapeutic Services combines naturopathic and family medicine to help all your health needs. Diabetic management, hypertension, pain management, and anti-aging are just a few of the services offered by the Ayers family. Call 352-512-0222 today, and Ayers Therapeutic Services will help you begin to understand that better health begins with you.
Do you experience body aches, joint, or muscle pain all over your body? Does it keep you up at night, interfere with your day, and leave you feeling tired and in pain? You could be suffering from fibromyalgia,
RedStar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study of investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 18 and 75 who have had widespread body pain or tenderness for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication at no cost. Compensation for time and travel will be provided, and insurance is not necessary to participate. If you experience body aches or suffer from fibromyalgia and would like to find out more information about this fibromyalgia study, please call RENSTAR Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's RENSTAR Medical Research, 352-629-5800. RENSTAR Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Howdy, RL here for Dairy Queen. Spring is in the air, and so is the smell of meat cooking on our charbroil grill. You want to treat yourself to one of our most excellent grilled chicken sandwiches or wraps, or maybe a foot-long all-beef chili dog, and wash it down with an orange Julius fruit smoothie with many real fruit flavors. So come on down to Dairy Queen Silver Springs, where we always treat you like kings and queens.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hello friends, this is Avelio Silvera inviting you to the 23rd annual Silver River Friends of the NRA Dinner. Our upcoming charitable banquet is on September 10th, 2015 at 5:30 p.m. and this year at a brand new location, the Circle Square Cultural Center at On Top of the World. The $50 per person ticket gives you access to games, a live auction, silent auction, raffles, prizes, and a whole lot of fellowship and fun, not to mention a seafood and chicken dinner buffet. You're going to want to be at the Silver River Friends of the NRA dinner on September the 10th at Circle Square Cultural Center. You can call Connie Davis at 352-239-0711. Again, that's Connie Davis at 352-239-0711. This is our charitable fundraising for the year so that we can empower the next generation of defenders of the Second Amendment.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source, 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
This is Southern Pigskin Tonight with host Buddy Martin on the Southern Pigskin Radio Network.
Hello and welcome to Southern Pigskin Tonight. I'm your host, Buddy Martin, coming to you in the southernmost outpost of the Southern Pigskin Radio Network from our WOCA studios here in beautiful Ocala. Tom Smith joins me again, as he does every week on Southern Pigskin Tonight. And Tom, do you know what the sound of that bugle means?
Yeah, I sure do, buddy. That means the same thing as this.
Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines.
Indeed, the call to post for both animal and machine.
And now the call to post for gators.
Ah, yeah, Tom, I'll be hearing that sound Saturday night in Ben Hill Griffin Stadium. I have to say it, though, on Florida Field. It's a song I've been hearing for more than 50 years and just as sweet as ever.
Of course it is, buddy, and I'll be right there with you. And that sound means
football season is here.
Okay, enough for the sound effects, Tom. I know you're excited. We're going to have plenty of fireworks around here for the next 4-plus months. And speaking of fireworks, Deflategate is finally over.
Thank goodness.
Tom Brady is ready to suit up. The judge ruled against Commissioner Roger Goodell of the NFL. Apparently agrees with Terry Bradshaw that Deflategate was a bunch of hot air. For some of you out there hearing this program now, the fireworks may have already started with the Battle of the Carolinas. Once again, South Carolina ushering in the new season with the traditional Thursday night season opener. We caught up with Coach Steve Spurrier just for a moment a few days ago and asked him about his Gamecocks and their game against the Tar Heels. Coach Steve Spurrier, who tees it up against North Carolina in Charlotte, and will be playing the Battle of the Carolinas. And tell us about your team, the progress. John Hoke, of course, has made a difference on defense. I noticed you made a comment in the scrimmage that only one guy broke a tackle, that you made all the tackles, something very important to your defense last year. What have you seen that you like about this new defense that John Hoke is part of?
Well, buddy, hopefully, and I use that word a lot because we haven't played a real ball game yet. We're just practicing, and practice is important, but what you do in the games is most important. Last year at this time, our defense actually looked pretty good against our offense, and we thought we were going to be pretty good on defense, and we ended up giving up more yards than any defense in school history. So we worked very good, and we were pretty good in preseason. So we're believing that's not going to happen this year. We're believing that we're going to get lined up. We can play physical, play smart, fundamentally sound, be a good tackling team, don't get beat deep, don't beat ourselves, obviously. So we'll wait and see if we can do that. I don't want to brag on our guys too much until the real ball games start. But our practices have been encouraging. I think that's the word. They're all encouraging. And we believe we'll show that we're a good team Thursday night.
Our thanks to the head ball coach for taking the time out to chat with us in what promises to be a challenging season for South Carolina. You know, Tom, as excited as everybody was to get the season underway and see a border rivalry game between the ACC and SEC, they didn't have the turnout they expected. Late Thursday, they still had 20,000 seats unsold.
Well, buddy, that's because somebody forgot to mention the prices.
Wow.
The head ball coach said it's like a Super Bowl game. You know, he paid $247 just for his wife's ticket.
He didn't like to part with his money either. Steve Spurrier, starting us off on week one of college football 2015, but more good stuff to come. When you want to set the table for the beginning of the college football season down south, I can't think of two better guys. They're two of the most prominent voices in college football in the South, and coming up next, we'll be talking to Paul Feinbaum of the Paul Feinbaum Show and Tony Barnhart, both of them of SEC Network, of course. I don't know about you, Tom. When I get to this point in the season, I've just got to sit down with a couple of my buddies and noodle out what's ahead for the next few months.
You mean like a football roundtable discussion, buddy?
Exactly, sort of like that. But what we should talk about? What will we talk about? I mean, what should we expect?
Exactly, that's what we'll talk about. What we expect to happen in college football this season, 2015.
You got it. Coming up in segment three with our pal and colleague, Tom James.
And don't forget, buddy, we've got the NFL season right behind next week.
No Deflategate. Woohoo! Right you are. Which is why we're going to talk to one of the experts about a team who will probably win more games in Florida than any other NFL squad, the Miami Dolphins. Coming up later in the show, distinguished columnist, journalist David Hyde of the Sun Sentinel in South Florida will join us for some insight on the Miami Dolphins. But first, let's head up I-95 to Brunswick, Georgia, and talk with 3-and-out host Kevin Thomas and SouthernPixian.com publisher B.J. Bennett. They're heard weekdays on 790 AM and 103.7 FM in Brunswick, 1400 AM and 104.3 FM in Savannah Hilton Head, and 1350 in Blackshear Waycross. Kevin, we just about worn out all these storylines, so let's pick some games. I understand you guys got a couple for us.
Thanks, buddy. Good to be here with you on Southern Pigskin tonight. And I got to say, we are all excited because the opening weekend of college football is here. And certainly that means big games all over. But given our time frame here, we're going to look at the SEC, some of the games coming up this weekend. Western Kentucky, Vanderbilt, an interesting matchup where Western Kentucky actually favored. But you get into the weekend. Obviously, Georgia still has unresolved quarterback issues. Ole Miss has got some quarterback things going on there. Bowling Green, Tennessee. I mean, this is Tennessee all offseason. Everybody, BJ, been hyping them up about it's Butch Jones and Tennessee. They're going to take a huge step forward. You come out of the gate and struggle with Bowling Green. maybe puts a damper on some of that. But some big games, and obviously some tune-up games where we get our first look at some of these teams.
Yeah, and look, everybody's excited about Alabama, Wisconsin, and Texas A&M, Arizona State. But there are some games that potentially could be more interesting than you think. And a lot of quarterback situations to watch. But the Saturday slate, Western Kentucky, Vanderbilt, that's an absolutely critical game for Vanderbilt. Because if you lose that, where else are you going to look on your schedule and feel good? I mean, Kevin, honestly, not to discredit Vanderbilt before the season starts, but you've got to win that one. In our state, I think the expectation is that Grayson Lambert, the starter at quarterback, will play a good bit, but you'll also see Bryce Ramsey some. So certainly all eyes on the quarterback at Georgia, all eyes on the quarterback at Ole Miss, as they have three or four guys they could rotate between as they take on FCS, UT Martin. Arkansas hosting UTEP, of course. It's going to be the Alex Collins show at running back as Jonathan Williams is out for the season. There is one running back in college football right now, Kevin, with multiple 1,000-yard rushing seasons on his resume. Do you know who it is? Alex Collins of Arkansas. So if anybody's capable of carrying the load, this guy can do it. And, boy, up in Atlanta, Louisville-Auburn going to be a lot of fun.
Absolutely. And, again, while we have a minute, let's look at some of the highlight games here this weekend. You got Louisville-Auburn in Atlanta. Bobby Petrino's got a better team, I think, than people think. They got quarterback issues. But a couple of guys that transferred from Georgia on that defense now eligible. I think people are chalking this up as an Auburn victory. I say not so fast. I think Louisville's going to give them a better game.
I think Auburn's got to earn it. I agree with you. A lot of hype around the Tigers. I am buying in. I picked them to win the West and actually win the league at SEC Media Days. But Louisville's better than people think. They had a top 10 defense nationally a year ago. You think Bobby Petrino, you think offense. That defense has been very, very good. So a solid test for Jeremy Johnson. Expectations very high for him. Kind of the Cam Newton lookalike, big, physical, kind of small forward, basketball-looking quarterback there for the Tigers, who I think is going to be great, has said all the right things this preseason, but you're spot on. Louisville's defense is pretty good. And, Kevin, what's the over-under for total points, Arizona State and Texas A&M?
I think you're
going to see 80 in this one?
I think you're talking 80 to 90. I mean, again, Texas A&M, I think all of their preseason thought is we know they can score. Nobody's doubting that Kevin Sumlin can score against SEC defenses. He's done it. What is the John Chavis factor? And we don't know.
In game one
against a team that can also score points. I don't know. I mean, if John Chavis takes a little longer to get that defense going than maybe people expect, I think Texas A&M is going to have another year kind of like they did last year. And I think I actually picked them down near the bottom of the SEC West when we did our predictions, simply because if you can't play defense in that league, it doesn't matter if it's Arkansas, Mississippi State, Ole Miss, Alabama. It doesn't matter. You're not going to be able to hold on and win a whole lot of football games. So I think that's an interesting one. I think Texas A&M, I will give them a slight edge in that football game over Arizona State.
They're at home.
Because they're at home. But I think there's going to be a lot of points scored in that one. And then obviously Saturday night, BJ1 that everybody's kind of looking forward to, another neutral site game, Wisconsin and Alabama. Alabama's got quarterback situations going on there, and Wisconsin's just the type of team that plays physical. They run the football. They know how to play defense. If Alabama's not ready at the quarterback position, that one could get very interesting.
I don't see it. I think even if Alabama gets marginal quarterback play, you have Derrick Henry, you have Kenyon Drake, you have maybe the nation's best front seven. I think Alabama will do what they've done in season openers of this ilk, high-profile season openers, they'll win. And Kevin, Tennessee could get a little tight against Bowling Green. Potentially, Missouri should have it on cruise control against Southeast Missouri State. Kentucky, Louisiana could be interesting. Of course, Jim McElwain in Florida will debut with New Mexico State. LSU hosting McNeese State. And Mississippi State at Southern Miss.
Yeah, that one could get interesting just because it's an in-state game, and I know Southern Miss hasn't traditionally gotten games against Ole Miss and Mississippi State. So a big slate. We're glad it's here. It's the opening weekend of the college football season, and we couldn't be more excited about it. And certainly, as you look in the SEC, a lot of intriguing matchups here in the first Saturday of college football. That's going to do it for us here. Buddy, we'll send it back to you here on Southern Pigskin tonight.
Thanks very much, Kevin. It's time for us to make some of our quick six picks as we sweep around the South for some last-minute notes. We got a few. I like Alabama over Wisconsin, Utah over Michigan, TCU over Minnesota, but in a tight one, Minnesota better than some people think, Auburn over Louisville, Notre Dame over Texas, and Ohio State over Virginia Tech. What you got, Tom?
Well, buddy, I got TCU over Minnesota as well, but remember, Minnesota was 8-5 last year. A lot better than anybody thought. I got Utah
in the cupcake game beating Michigan.
I got your cupcake.
I got Auburn taking on Louisville in the opening game with Auburn winning it. Arizona State and Texas A&M, that's going to be a closer game than anybody thinks, but Texas A&M will pull that one out in the end. BYU over Nebraska. I think BYU's got a legitimate Heisman Trophy candidate in that quarterback of theirs. And here's a barn burner that you don't want to watch,
buddy.
That you don't want to watch. Vanderbilt will lose to Western Kentucky.
And it's over in Nashville. That happens. I guess the big news is that we finally got some news about starting quarterbacks, Tom. All around the South, Spurrier was first with Connor Mitch. And, of course, we don't have any word yet from Nick Saban of Alabama, who still hasn't picked his, but other things happening.
Well, Jim McElwain finally chose his starter, buddy, Treon Harris over Will Grier. A little bit of a surprise, but Jim McElwain said both quarterbacks will play.
Yeah, he said on the SEC coaches' teleconference that Harris and Grier will not alternate every series. He said both will have a set of scripted plays, and they'll run those in the first part of the game. Jimbo Fisher went with Notre Dame transfer Everett Golson. Mark Richt chose Virginia transfer Grayson Lambert over Bryce Ramsey. One more note about Florida. In honor of the late